Hello farmers and welcome back to Let's Play Farming Simulator 2013 on the Holzhausen map. So, just gonna put on the timer, there we go. So we are back on the Holzhausen, the Let's Play here. I haven't really done anything just right before I started here. I moved the combine over to the other wheat field, nothing else really, so as well I started a little bit on raking, but that's pretty much all. Doing it quite fast here, but yeah, yet again it's been a while since the last episode, but at least on well, I can't remember which day it was, but a few days ago anyways, I signed under the agreement with TGN, so we are partnering with them, so you folks know that. So that's something I've been doing for a few days ago as well. We got the new snow plow ready and we got it home, so need to unload that and stuff like that. Took a little bit, as well, you know, as well they tested it, well they haven't really tested it on plowing anything. It'd be interesting in the winter, see if the New Holland can handle the snow plow or not. It does say on it, well at least on the website from the company that makes those particular snow plows, that it should be maximum, pulled by maximum 120 horsepower, or 120 horsepower tractor, so. And New Holland TD54 is 88 horsepower, so it should be fine, really. But yeah, as well, I have a snow plow on and everything, tested everything works on it, you know, like hydraulics and stuff like that. Everything works beautifully, really. It's a little bit different. Well, and yeah, I suspect if you don't know what I'm talking about on a snow plow, no, after I said this. I'll take a look at those pictures on my Facebook page if you have Facebook, and yeah, you can see the snowplow there amongst some other things that I have posted from real life equipment, like the Valmet, a Scranner, lawnmower tractor, Scranner rider, and the snowplow. It's been posted different pictures there and stuff, so you can go take a look. But see if we can get back to this talking about the snow plow. So the only thing with her is when I'm supposed to kind of turn around the blade on the back, it can be a little bit difficult. But it's just something it used to, I suppose. That's the only thing. But it's fine. It's like a kind of a hydraulical thing that turns a blade on the back around. Let's go on my Facebook to take a look at the blade if you're wondering what I'm talking about. But yeah, I might make a different video, a real life video about that someday. Not today anyway, because it's raining. But if it's a nice day, I'm gonna see if making some videos about the Scranner and the new snow plow for the tractor. But what else? Well, towards the weekend here, I work on the farm again. I do apologize for saying for ages ago that I was supposed to make some more videos about that, but I haven't been any work. I haven't needed any help, so. But now he wanted some help, or I don't know what he's supposed to do this weekend, but he needed me. So I set up to work Saturday morning, Saturday evening, Sunday morning, and Sunday evening. So yeah, it's gonna be a few shifts, four shifts there to take. But that's fine. As well, there's a lot of things that have changed. But I think it's gonna come back to that in a second. Just gonna go and get the baler. I'm gonna bore you folks with me driving over there. So, see you folks in a bit. Okay then. We are back. Let's do this. 25 centimeter bales? Yeah, I think that's right. Okay then, let's continue here. So, where was I with the farming, real life farming stuff? Well, yes, the new stuff we have, or stuff that have changed since I was the last. Well, first of all, the calves that was on the out on the field last time I made a video, out on the pasture, whatever you say, they are back in, so the barn is quite full. I'm noticing I need to fill up this tractor with diesel. Oh well, if they do that in a bit, but yeah, all the calves are back and everything. As well, it's a I think the barn can hold originally, I would say 80 animals, and then it's like some pens for sick animals and stuff like that, but you know, the farmer of course uses that for the good ones as well. You have seen all the in the main farm there, all the pens and stuff like that be filled up, the front one's actually supposed to not be, but yeah, well, it gets a little bit extra work if it gets a sick bull. You just have to take it out of there and make your own pen for it, but enough of that. That's one thing as well. I can show you folks, you know, that particular thing that it does that is fine, because it's an okay sized pen there. Still a bit small. But what he has done as well is putting in two calves all the way in the back. The kind of, you know, where the calves usually is in the barn there. I'm going to show you folks in one of the videos, I think, instead of trying to explain. And please say enough fuel for this. Don't tell me I'm going to run out. Ugh. That skills. Oh well, but yeah, I'm gonna show you folks more of what you have done, but it, you know, I think it was like under 80 animals in the barn when I made those videos. But those, of course, in the front there, that what I'm saying, it with 80 animals, or maybe down to, well, the main barn that I've shown you folks, I try to think here. You know, as well, he has one other one that I've kind of shown a few glimpses of. They are connected, but it's not, you know, the older building and the new one. I think the new one, if he didn't use the pens, he told me is for the sick animals, it will be probably about like 60 or something like that. And then with the those pens, it's like 8 more animals. The old building, 16, you can have in there. Then they have some calves that goes, I'm not sure how it set it up, but anyway, I think it's like 96, but like 92 animals in the barn now. So, and it was a max when I was working earlier this year, before the summer, it was about 88 or something like that, 86, 88 animals. And then there was a lot of work. And we have about 4 more animals. I can't remember if it was 92. Maybe it was 90. Only 2 more. Don't know, but yeah. I can show you folks how we did that. And no, they are not pushed into one of the other pens. So it's no... it's no more animals in any pens. It's rather... I can show you folks it. Yeah. Did have a laugh inside me when I saw that. If I say it like that, somebody can accidentally let go of a bull out of the building very easily. Oh, it wasn't a bull, it was a... not a cow, well, it's technically a cow, it's a female, but... no, it's... before... she haven't had a cow, those... what do you call... a cow that haven't had a calf? In English, do you still just say cow? Because we have a different word in Norwegian, but I don't know if English English speaking, you say it differently. But anyway, it's like, you know, females going around there. Some kind of... it's hard to explain. I guess you can give up to try to explain it. Trying too hard to explain and realize, no, I have not a clue how I was supposed to explain it. But yeah, I can make a video of it. I think it's quite funny. But you have to stay tuned to the weekend or something like that. I will show that. Whenever it gets nice weather, we'll show off the two new things for us here as well. The Snowblade and Husqvarna. I will be done when it's nice weather outside, because I don't want to stand outside when it's raining on me and try to make a video. So it might rain on the camera and then it might be a little bit difficult to record. But yeah, anyway, for that, my English. Okay, that's another bale, and I might pause the video as well. It's like, great, now I run out of things to talk about. As well, thank you folks for seeing me bale a few times. So I think I will pause the video and be back. I mean, the end of baling this field. So yeah, let's see you folks in a second. So hang on. Okay, so we're coming to the end of the video, I guess. I actually forgot the timer when I started last time, so don't really know how far we're into the video. But I'm at least done with the field. But I think I'm going to talk about, well, yeah, I think I'm going to talk about a few things. Let's try to not make that into a grass bale. That's enough. If I pick up those small bits there, it's going to be a grass bale. But anyway, I guess I'm just going to get out of this. There you go. Here she goes. So, if you're still hanging on here to the end of the video, I wanted to say a few things. There's one, I don't think gonna be any more Farming Sim 2013 mod spotlights. So I kinda took a break from that, mainly because I didn't have any good mods. But I know like the Ferguson pack stuff that came out, but so many people did it, a spotlight on it. So I decided, well, let that be, and then wasn't too many good mods before the Steyr, I think it's a case, a Steyr CVX 230. Boy, oh, I think I gotta make the small Steyrs. You know, the small Steyr that I did for a while, not the old one, not the old Smoky, but the smaller ones. Can't remember the number. But yeah, same guy. I guess he kind of. Kind of did like a reskin or rework on the in-game, or titanium, I suppose to say. Oh, I got the verse today, but yeah, the titanium add-on case. It seems like he had done some work from that. If I said like that, I wish the case was that good, done, because that mod is definitely very nice. So if you're a Steyr fan and haven't seen that one, I'm gonna show you and another mod that I think you mostly know about. So hopefully we'll be able to buy both of those tractors, both tractors, before FS15 comes out. So I have to do my best to see if we get a few episodes up here. Maybe do some off-camera work, I don't know. Just have to see how it goes. But I think I'll show you folks these mods just quick in the shop before the end of this episode. It's on sale. Okay. Should really do some forced mod stuff as well. So much you should do before FS15, but Oh well, I have to see if how many episodes we can make, but tractors. Tire, can do this tire first. Both of these tractors are mold huster. So there we go. I don't know if you folks have seen her before. Did I say Steyr 230? Yeah, anyway. Steyr 6230 CVT. So, yeah. Very nice mod. Definitely recommend it. I'm not the big Steyr fan myself, but you know, the same author that made this one. This guy here. Very, very nice mod. I think these ones was okay. Well, that was very nice. Nothing wrong with them. But this one definitely has a ton of nice features inside the cabin animation and stuff like that. Like the computer thing inside there fires up properly. And see the joystick moving, light stuff, fuel gauges, pedals, IC, all kinds of things. Really recommend it. Very, very nice. As well, they had the dynamic exhaust from the titanium on it. So, yeah, very nice. It's about 270 horsepower. So, definitely a little beast there. Something I really want to buy in this A game here. This is a very nice tractor. And then we have one more. As well, this one. With the, well, you know, for me, on the top mods on the tractors, I think, in New Holland TM, this one, and most likely the 933 Fantathys as well, if you haven't seen it. Really recommend going down on this one as well. It is a mode hoster. It should be, you search on this, or just go on the Fant, you will find it. It's by Argo, so, you know. He's famous for his John Deere's and the other fancy he made. But I don't really think I can do any more spotlights. I've already seen Predator Gaming anyway done a spotlight kind of thing on this one. And a good few people I've seen using it. So I think most people know about it. But you know, it's already the one people that doesn't. But now you know, it's a mode hoster. It's just click on the link to this map and then, well, just go and search on them. It's the names that it was in the shop. It should be anyway. But you will find them. But yeah. Or if you need any help to find them, well, just ask. I would be willing to give you the link. But I'm not going to post links if nobody's interested. So if you're interested, can't find it, just give me a comment and I'll send you the link. But yeah. I see you all soon. And have a nice day. Bye-bye.